Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. High-risk pregnancies are on the rise in the United States, as are conditions that arise during pregnancy, such as gestational diabetes. What are the signs of gestational diabetes and how do you treat it? Joining us is obstetrician and gynecologist, Dr. Roman Starikov. He specializes in maternal and fetal medicine at Scripps Clinic in La Jolla, California. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
So what is gestational diabetes?
Gestational diabetes is a condition that is unique to pregnancy. It is specific conditions that woman gets diagnosed only while she is pregnant and not diagnosed outside of pregnancy.
And what are the symptoms?
The symptoms of gestational diabetes are usually not present, not typical symptoms of excessive thirst, excessive urination, or excessive eating that you see in people who are having diabetes symptoms outside of pregnancy. Usually people do not have any symptoms.
So how is gestational diabetes diagnosed?
Gestational diabetes is diagnosed with a 1 hour sugar tolerance test. Basically you drink a solution and they check your sugar 1 hour. This is a screening test. If this test is abnormal, the doctor usually orders a 3 hour sugar test where you drink a solution and they check four different values before you drink, 1 hour after, 2 hour after, and 3 hour after.
What causes gestational diabetes?
Gestational diabetes is caused by pregnancy itself. There are hormones that are released from the placenta that are making women to be resistant to glucose, meaning she cannot produce enough insulin to lower her sugar in her blood.
And how does gestational diabetes affect your unborn child?
Gestational diabetes can affect unborn child in many different ways. Most of the studies do show that having high blood sugar during pregnancy accelerates growth of the child, and usually the child gains much more weight than it potentially should be gaining out without gestational diabetes. This in turn can result in a bigger baby and injuries during the childbirth and delivery.
So who is at risk for gestational diabetes?
Women who are at risk for gestational diabetes are women who have strong family history of gestational diabetes, also mothers who are overweight or have medical conditions such as diabetes. Also, women who are at risk for gestational diabetes are those who had a previously very large baby.
So you just mentioned this. So is gestational diabetes genetic? If your mom had it, does this mean that you are going to have gestational diabetes when you're pregnant?
There is a genetic component of gestational diabetes, and it is also sometimes can be what we call window to the woman's future, because a lot of these women are at increased risk for having type 2 diabetes or diabetes outside of pregnancy. So yes, it is strongly linked to a family history and to further developing type 2 diabetes later in a woman's life.
So why is gestational diabetes on the rise? Why are high-risk pregnancies on the rise in general?
There's many factors that contribute to the rise of gestational diabetes. Certainly, obesity in the population is a significant factor. Nutrition and eating foods that are high in carbohydrates or high in sugar increase risk. And also a lot of pregnancies are now in women who are older and delay their childbearing until older age. And obviously age is also a risk factor. So
how do you manage diabetes during pregnancy?
The management of diabetes during pregnancy can be quite simple. For majority of women, the management involves simple dietary modifications, such as decreasing amount of sugar intake. We don't want pregnant women to be eating cookies, cakes, anything that has high number or high glycemic index. Basically, some of them, sometimes if that doesn't work, you may need to have pills, or some women may need to take insulin.
So you mean a shot of insulin?
Yes.
Okay. Talk about the Scripps Perinatology program that is geared towards helping these high-risk pregnancies.
The program involves certified diabetic educators who are nurses. It involves nutritionists. It involves endocrinologists. And it involves one of us who are perinatologists or high-risk obstetricians and gynecologists. We talk about patients as a group. We review each patient as a group, and we decide what's the most appropriate management and offer it to the patient to get the best outcome from pregnancy.
And you follow them a lot more closely during pregnancy?
Usually we follow them a lot closely. They have many more appointments, and some of them include antenatal testing, which is putting on a monitor a woman prior to childbirth to make sure that baby is doing well and not affected by high sugars.
Can gestational diabetes be cured?
Gestational diabetes is a temporary condition that is specific to the pregnancy. Once the woman and baby is delivered, the gestational diabetes for majority of women is resolves and is cured. Although some women do end up having persistent diabetes, and it evolves into the type 2 diabetes that may require further treatment outside of pregnancy.
And if you don't get gestational diabetes under control, what can happen?
What can happen is baby can grow very large inside the woman's uterus, and that baby may need to be delivered by C-section. Or if a woman decides to attempt a vaginal delivery with a large baby, the baby can get stuck. It may require special maneuvers to be delivered. And after special maneuvers, some babies may result having a shoulder injury and also injury to the nerves that may paralyze arm temporarily or permanently.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
It is important to have gestational diabetes screened during pregnancy. We now screen every single woman for gestational diabetes during pregnancy. It is important to understand that you should not eat a lot of cookies, sugars, cakes, and increase in vegetable and fruit intakes. And if you get diagnosed with gestational diabetes, do not panic. Usually it is well-managed condition, and if it's appropriately managed, usually most of the women have excellent outcome.
Deliver a healthy baby.
Exactly.
Doctor, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you.
If you want more information on gestational diabetes, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media @Scripps Health. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.